Hey, how you doing? Is Paul around, please?
Yeah, I'll just run to the back of the ground for you.
Thanks.
How's it going? Paul?
Good. Doing well. Good to see you. I'm here. I'm doing a barbecue today, a rotisserie leg of lamb, and
all right.
I'd like to pick one up from you.
Yeah, I got some beautiful stuff. I just got in.
Awesome. Thanks. So
come around.
All right.
Stuff we got in this week, it's really great stuff.
Awesome, he's local, eh?
Yeah.
Where'd you get him from?
All our stuff's local. This stuff is from, I don't know what this supply is from. I think it's near
Oshawa. Perfect.
So the first step in breaking down a leg, we're gonna take the shoulders off and we're gonna do it the old fashioned way with a handsaw. It gives a cleaner cut and just a nice look all together.
So the way this is done, we count down ribs. It's not as easy to see on this one just because it's not split open.
But when we open them up, we can count the ribs down for us.
Yeah, I can show you again once it's opened up.
Perfect.
So I just like to give myself a mark there. Split it open. Now we can get a better look at it. So see, you start at the first rib. We're gonna count down 1, 2, 3, 4. And right in between there is where we take the shoulders off. And the reason you do that is because after the fourth rib, you get 7 real nice rib bones in here, which is where the rack of lamb comes from.
Sweet. Which is a different awesome cut unto itself.
Yeah. So that's our shoulders. We'll just stick those aside for now. Then the next part in getting us a boneless leg of lamb would be to take the legs off of the loin. Now for this, we turn it around. You kind of feel for the small of the back, just like on a person, where it kind of bends just down. You can feel the
little
bone in the,
yeah, nice little notch in there.
So we're gonna take the saw to that, just cut straight through the spine.
Now obviously this isn't something you can do at home, so you have a nice butcher,
yeah,
make him your buddy, you throw him a couple extra dollars at the end of the day and
he'd be happy to do it.
Yeah.
Up a fight. There we go. So this would be, I know it's not necessary, but this is your loin and rib section of the lamb. Your rack of lamb is gonna come 7 bones from here.
Okay.
So that's the part that a lot of people are used to the lamb chops from and the rib chops, the nice ones with the French bone. And after that, you've got your loin for the basic lamb loin chops. Looks similar to a T-bone steak, but from a lamb. We'll put that aside too. And these are our 2 legs. I'm just gonna take it over to the bandsaw and split it in half along the spine.
Now, is it easier to split the legs of lamb with the bandsaw than doing it,
yeah,
by hand?
Just getting the accurate cut when you're together like this, because of the shape of the bone, as you can see, it's a sort of oddly shaped bone. It's harder to go through at a clean angle, so you're always better off to do it this way.
Makes them really nice and symmetrical.
Now the first step in doing a boneless leg, you're gonna wanna take the shank off so you get the nice roast part of the meat. So we'll take that back over to the bandsaw. One quick cut.
Now what would you use this guy for?
That lamb shank, you could treat it as if you would, well, any other shank from an animal. You could braise it, use it for soup. A lot of people, you'll take the main part of it and you can throw it in when you're doing a soup. You can use it for stew. It's a slow cooking meat though.
But versatile.
Now butterflying, as you know, basically means that it's opened up as a butterfly's wings would be spread. So again, we're looking for this seam in here, which will separate the muscles from each other.
So whenever you find a seam, those are the best ways to cut, butterfly it open.
If you're butterflying something or trying to stuff something, you want to look for a seam because that way it's the most natural way. I mean, we could just start cutting into this and folding it back, but then you're going to have damaged meat that's not done the natural way. So if you take it along the natural seams, then it folds back easy, it cooks really well, and you just get a better end result.